October cold fronts are often the catalyst for successful hunts. As the calendar inches toward November, scrapes appear under overhanging branches and rub lines connect the dots between a buck's bed and where he feeds. October 21st brings the best cold front of the season. It is a welcomed event for Jared Mills as he heads to a stand on the river farm.
Alright, it's October 21st and I'm gonna keep this short and sweet. We got some deer out in this plot already. It's only 4:40. We saw our first deer. Well, actually, I was hanging the stand and I could see some deer like 40 yards just milling around the bedding area. We've already watched a couple bucks heading out across the middle of the farm, and now there's four deer right here, a couple fawns just bedded down in the clover. So that is a really good sign for the night. It's by far the earliest movement I've seen all season. We've got a really good cold front right now, or that just came through. So it's clearly got the deer moving. This is a familiar spot. Last year in mid-October, Grant killed the deer we called Bob at a stand about 25 yards away. And I decided to come in. There's this good looking oak tree right here. That stand was good. It produced some really good hunts for us. But it was just a little bit too far off and the deer tend to work out away from that stand. And so it pushes that bow shot a lot further. I think Grant's is probably like 43 yards. I think it's going to be a good night, at least as far as seeing deer. We're not necessarily in Merino's core, but you never know. We're not too terribly far off either, so hoping we can at least see a good buck. Be good to lay eyes on deck for the first time this season too, so can't wait to see how it unfolds.
While Jared waits for buck movement, 130 miles to the southwest, Owen Riegler is also looking to take advantage of the cold front.
Man, this feels like killing weather right here. This has got to be the best feeling day we've had so far. It's actually cold. All right, fellas, here we go again, October 21st. It's about, I'll tell you what time it is, 4 o'clock right now. So we got roughly 3 hours to set in here. We got corn here, corn on that side, corn clear back. So we're in a nice little hub kind of in the middle of three mature bucks use this area. They kind of overlap. We got Wolverine we could see down here, that tweezers buck. We'll throw up a picture of him. We haven't introduced him yet, but he's a 5-year-old deer. And then there's a 10 that keeps showing up. He was on that scrape right there. I've got a cuttyback set on that scrape right there. He was on that about, I think it was about 6:30, he was on that last night. I'd like to see him in person. He looks pretty darn nice. I don't know the deer, which is not very common on this farm. I know about all of them, but it's kind of cool when one shows up, you don't know. So we're gonna stick with the strategy of just hunting food in the evenings and kind of bouncing around to different food sources so we don't overhunt one. But here in the next few days, we might start hunting mornings. That's the plan. We'll set in here and see how it goes. We got a buck resting in doe. It sounds like in that corn they keep making a pretty good disturbance. We just haven't seen them yet. Start wheeze at him, see what he does. Coming down the path. was a neat encounter. I snort-wheezed at him up there on the top edge of that corn, hoping he'd come down, we could get a better look at him. Well, we got a look at him, all right. He was right here 10 yards for the longest time. I couldn't put that deer past 4 years old. Beauty, though. Well, we got about, I think, 45 minutes left. Hopefully the buck parade continues.
As the magnificent four-year-old works his way out of sight, Owen fears that will conclude his evening. Meanwhile, Jared is still awaiting a mature buck sighting.
He's scraping now. He's fired up. Pretty sure that's that eight.
CRB right now, up through the grass. There's something raking in the willows. There's something raking a willow tree. It might be.
It's almost gotta be him, but it's whatever it is, it's tearing up a willow tree.
We had some excitement there. All those does and fawns were out working out in front of us, and that, I think he's just a good 3-year-old, 10. Was working out in the plot, and for whatever reason, the wind just kind of switched directions. Instead of going northwest, it was coming straight out of the south, right up to those deer. And I can't figure it out, because this is not a swirling wind spot as far as like the topography and just the area in general. So it was just the wind, for whatever reason, just switching directions. And so it's pretty deflating when you have that many deer and the night's going really well and something like that happens. But then right after that, I spotted just a big mature eight, probably 200 yards away, walking straight away from us. I grunted a couple times and he turned on a dime, started scraping up the ground, got fired up. I thought maybe he's gonna march right in here. There was a buck that Ethan was maybe going to shoot, but a doe kind of got in between us, and I don't really know where he went from there. I could see a willow tree getting raked not too far, so I assume that was him. They're definitely moving good. I hate that I kind of got messed up right there with that wind switching, but it's about 6 o'clock right now, so hopefully it stays straight the rest of the night.
October's first cold front proved to be worthy of the hope such events bring, as both Jared and Owen encounter mature bucks well before the end of legal shooting time. Although neither bow hunter sees a buck he wishes to harvest, these sightings add fuel to the fire. Hunts like these make it easy to stay focused and ready amidst these refreshingly cool afternoons. With the drop in temps predicted to last another day, both men are excited for tomorrow. With the hunt still lingering, Mike Reed heads for an area frequented by his top target, a buck he calls Chubbs.
Well, it's Thursday, October 21st. and Ryan are back out at the home farm in the cherry tree. This front is pushing through. The wind has switched out of the northwest. The real feel is around 47 degrees. Wind speeds are like 17 miles per hour, so it's a little bit chilly. Overcast, pressure's on the rise, really nice conditions. I got stuck at the office later than I wanted to today. put a full day in and couldn't miss getting out here, especially after last night's hunt, you know, seeing a 6.5-year-old buck. I don't love hunting this spot with a northwest. We still have a little west-northwest, which I don't mind cutting this corner off. As the night goes on, it's supposed to get a little more north in it, which, you know, comes with some risk, but I didn't have enough time to make an adjustment or hang another set. So we're just back in the cherry tree. We're gonna take our chances. It's too good a conditions to catch chubs up on his feet. He was here at this scrape around 4 o'clock in the morning this morning. I think most of Chubbs' activity is down in that creek to the west and in that bowl in the alfalfa. So what I'm hoping is, you know, he pops up in these beans or pops up in the alfalfa and decides to come work this scrape or check this area for does. And I can call to him because my wind's going this way. We parked the truck down here, snuck up this fence line. Like I said, there's already deer out in the alfalfa. We didn't spook anything, so I'm excited for tonight.
While Mike's evening hunt proves uneventful, 200 miles to the southwest, in Missouri, Kyle Carey settles into a redneck blind with hopes of capitalizing on the cold front.
That deer came back in here and I decided to go ahead and take him. Oh, I don't know what deer that is. Might look like a 4-year-old to me. Now it's time to look forward to the youth season, get my girls out there and spend some time with them.
Morning of October 22nd starts cool and cloudy, but soon gives way to a gorgeous sunrise. Daylight arrives, revealing several deer still on their feet feeding through the beans. Early movement offers hope, but it quickly fades after the first hour of legal light. After a short break, Mike Reed sets his sights again on the cherry tree in the hopes of encountering chubs.
It's a little after 4, and Ryan and I are back up in the cherry tree. Got some work done midday today, and I've been overthinking where to sit tonight. We've got a northwest wind, which I like. It's switching around 7 o'clock to north, which I don't like as much. It's going to blow just straight across the plot. You gotta give up something like this stand, and it's just part of the problem. But one of the reasons I came here is because I have a 5-day stretch to hunt, and this will be the last hunt I can. You know, I've got Saturday through Tuesday, and we don't have any winds that work for this set. They're all easterly, and so I'm gonna have plenty of opportunities to try out some other areas around the farm, and I thought we'd come give it one more go. We've got great conditions. It's nice and cool. I actually, you know, we sat here this morning and we got down a little after 9 o'clock, and I got some pictures midday from the cell cam, and he was just to the south of here going back to bed in the bowl here, which is one of the spots that I know he likes to bed. It's about 8:50 in the morning, so I don't think he's bedded really all that far. So he's either gonna go out the way he came, go out in the alfalfa or the big cut cornfields to the south, or I'll pop up here for the turnips and the beans. I like him coming up with the wind in his face. There's a lot of trails that pop out just right over here, so I'm hoping our wind stays west enough. I've had a lot of luck kind of with those skiving winds where you're almost blowing the wrong wind, you know, so anyway, a little roll of the dice tonight. High anticipation hunt, hopefully makes an appearance and we can pull it off and get him down.
Thirty miles to the southwest, Owen Riegler is on stand, hoping to make the most of the cold front's final day.
Here we are, guys, October 22nd. We had a little, what do we want to say? A little bad time getting in, or just, anyway, there was a nice tan that was bedded in that standing corn right there. I was telling Joe, I was like, if we'd known he was there, we could have snuck into the stand, okay, but we're just walking nonchalant and he probably spotted us moving. But I know the buck, he's a nice framey tan. I'll throw some pictures of him up. He's been on this scrape. We got a rubbing post and a scrape right here. So we've got that split G2 buck. He could be up here. This is kind of in his core, this or the green source to the west. But Wolverine's been up here so we could see him. We tried to create a go-between right here in front of us with the food source on either side, trying to get them to move across here. So we'll see if that comes into play. It'd be a chip shot if they do. Those trail pictures didn't really do him justice. I knew he was a big deer, but seeing him in person, he was even bigger than I thought. Yeah, I won't sleep good tonight thinking about him. I tell you to get out of here. I think we're going to go back around this corn so we can go on that side of it to get out without him seeing us. Do not want that. I'll be back after him tomorrow. We'll see you guys then.
As Owen calms his nerves and begins to sneak from the woods, Mike is experiencing another high-activity sit in the cherry tree.
It's about 5:40, so we have about an hour left to go. The deer activity's been great. We've had deer moving since we sat down. We've seen six or seven out in the alfalfa. We've got a buck and a couple does. We've seen probably seen four or five does come out in the cut beans. Got another buck down here. Excited for this last hour. Yeah, it's Patient X. You see him? That'll get him to walk over here. just got back to the truck. Talk about a fun sit. We ended up seeing over 20 deer and over 10 different bucks. Most of them were just 1 and 2 year olds messing around. But we ended the night with Patient X in the cut beans, and he was at about 100 yards. He's at least a 5.5 year old, so that's 3 nights in a row out of that stand that we see deer that are at least 5.5 years old. So all these mature bucks on their feet is pretty exciting. No chubs, obviously, but it's nice to see him on his feet at 9 o'clock in the morning. So the winds are changing, and I'm gonna have to make some moves. I'm excited to kind of hunt around that alfalfa. It's gonna be neat to continue to learn the farm, and we'll be back out in the morning getting after him.
720 miles to the east, on the morning of October 23rd, Phil Scott makes an aggressive move on his New York farm.
Hey, well, good morning, guys. It's October 23rd. And snuck up in here in this set that I hung a few days ago. Right where we're having pictures of the 9 come out. I think this is one of two areas he beds. And after reviewing the footage from last night, that was definitely the 9. But it's a calm, still morning. It's 41 degrees. Got a southwest wind. And basically, it's all about the thermals today. So we should have, we got rising temps throughout the day. So should carry our thermals up and out of here. So right, I'm basically in the bedroom hoping he circles back around from a night out.
Summer. We've seen him last year, maybe a couple times. He's at 10. He's got a couple stickers on his G2s. Definitely a 4-year-old deer. Oh man, that was awesome. He was making a scrape right here. Oh, he was tearing that thing up. Looks like I made a good shot on him. I think I heard him go down too. Oh man, that was awesome. Mule kicked everything, so. Oh, that was sweet. Oh my God, what a morning. Holy cow.
Yeah, right here. Look at the blood.
Oh, here's the arrow.
There he is, Cal. Look it. Look it, buddy. He fell right in the trail. What's up with that?
Well, hey guys, glad to be sitting behind this deer. This is a deer we call the Sticker 10. Don't have a lot of history with him. We did see him on the hoof once early last year with the 9. And then we got one picture with him at the northwest corner of the property in August with another wide 8. And we just kind of wrote him off because we just didn't really have any pictures of him. So. Kind of considering him a bonus buck, and I'm just proud to be sitting behind this deer solo filming. is a culmination of a lot of hard work that we put in the off season, and I'm just happy to be sitting behind this deer.
Was a neat encounter. I snort wheezed at him up there on the top edge of that corn, hoping he'd come down, we could get a better look at him. Well, we got a look at him, all right. He was right here 10 yards for the longest time.
We ended the night with Patient X in the cut beans, and he was at about 100 yards. He's at least a 5.5-year-old, so that's 3 nights in a row out of that stand that we see deer that are at least 5.5 years old.
My goodness, guys, that was the buck we were hoping to see. Tell you, those trail pictures didn't really do him justice. I knew he was a big deer, but seeing him in person, he's even bigger than I thought. Yeah, I won't sleep good tonight thinking about him.
October cold fronts create opportunities and feed our anticipation of what lies ahead. As deer hunters, we crave the adrenaline spike that accompanies the whitetail rut. But the truth is, the pre-rut conditions of late October can often be our best chance at patterning one of these great bucks. As the days advance, the bucks are spending more time moving in daylight. We sit at the stoplight, ready to make our run when the light turns green. Like a drag racer on the line, it is the coming adrenaline-fueled chaos that we crave. Now, only a few sunsets stand between today and when we will again be chasing November.